Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here. Now just by looking at them, it's hard to imagine that these tiny little plastic pellets can actually lower nitrates in your aquarium and even phosphate to a small extent. Well, in reality, it's actually bacteria that does all of the work. However, biopellets are the catalyst that your tank needs to heavily produce this helpful nitrate reducing bacteria. In this video, we're going to tell you guys all about how biopellets work and show you some helpful tips that will make using biopellets on your aquarium easy and effective. In your aquarium, there is an abundance of bacteria that consume nitrates, phosphate, and carbon. Because an aquarium is an enclosed environment in which nitrates and phosphates are readily available, the limiting factor for bacteria growth is a carbon source, and this is where biopellets come into the picture. Biopellets are made from a pure, biodegradable plastic. When added to your aquarium in a biopellet reactor, these pellets act as a carbon source for bacteria. The best way to think of this is that biopellets are a sort of food for bacteria. With the extra supply of carbon available, extra bacteria starts to grow on the pellets and consume nitrates and phosphates. Once biopellets are added to the reactor, it generally takes 4 to 6 weeks for the bacteria colony to establish. Additives such as Brightwell Microbacter 7 or Two Little Fishies Bactiv 8 will help to speed up this process. The bacteria works quickly to reduce nutrients, so you'll want to start slow by adding only about 25% of the recommended amount of biopellets to your reactor. Then add about 25% more biopellets to the reactor each week thereafter until you have reached the full recommended dose. This way, you'll avoid a drastic decrease in nitrates and phosphates, which can cause stress on your aquarium animals. Also, don't forget to soak the biopellets in a cup of aquarium water for 24 hours prior to use, because this will prevent the pellets from floating inside the reactor. Once the bacteria has established inside your reactor, it will start to consume the pellets along with nitrates and a small amount of phosphate. For every 16 parts of nitrate that is removed, there is one part of phosphate that is removed, and this is called the Redfield ratio. Now this is why biopellets are the most effective to reduce nitrates in your tank, but will also have a small effect on phosphate. The bacteria coats the surface of the biopellets and creates a biofilm. As the pellets tumble inside the reactor, they rub against each other, and then this biofilm sheds off, exits the reactor, and is then exported from your tank via a protein skimmer. New surface area is then exposed for new bacteria to colonize and continue reducing nitrates and phosphate. For this reason, biopellets must be used in conjunction with a good protein skimmer, and you will want to direct the outlet of your biopellet reactor towards the inlet of your protein skimmer. It is perfectly normal to expect much more skimmit to be collected when using biopellets, so be sure to maintain and clean your skimmer accordingly. Now, as long as the biopellets are tumbling thoroughly, then they're working. However, in some extreme cases, when the pellets are tumbling too fast, the biofilm never gets a chance to establish, so in this scenario, simply decrease the flow rate through your reactor. It is crucial to understand that all three elements, nitrate, phosphate, and a carbon source, are needed for the bacteria to grow. If there is no presence of phosphates in your aquarium, then that means that bacteria will be unable to consume nitrates. So if you're using GFO or some other form of phosphate control, be sure to keep the levels minimal but still present. With all of the gorgeous saltwater fish out there, it's really hard not to overstock your aquarium. Inevitably, most all of us will probably run into a nitrate problem at some point or another, but thanks to biopellets, we can now effectively control nitrate levels in even the most heavily stocked aquariums. If you found this video helpful, please like and share it to help spread the word. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all of the latest MarineDepot.com videos. And until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.